There's nothing to worry about.
Okay.
No one ever comes out here. We're safe. I promise.
So, how does this work exactly?
Just like any other old sale, except cash only, and for obvious reasons, no receipts. I'll do you a half ounce for a 20. What do you say? It's plenty of bang for your buck. Should last you a while. Hey, we don't need to do this. Just give me the word, and I'll just walk away.
Okay? No, it's not that I don't want you to go. It's just, do you ever feel like you're losing your mind?
You know, just on a daily basis. I mean, I feel like I'm losing my mind right now doing a drug deal with Chrissy Cunningham, the queen of Hawkins High.
Stranger danger, talking stranger things together forever. We're loving stranger things. It's Stranger Things forever. Rewatching season 4 from the start to the finish. It's Stranger Things forever. Every podcast we do will cover just 10 minutes. Stranger danger everywhere. I hope that you people still care. It's time for me to do it. Let's get to it. Come on, everyone.
Greetings, stranger friends, and welcome back to Stranger Things Forever. We're back again. It's Sunday night. I am finally sitting down to talk about the next installment of the Hellfire Club. Today we're talking about, what, minutes 40 to 50. I had to realize episode one started with minute zero. So episode two starts with minute 10 and so forth and so forth. I want to thank everyone who's been listening to it, who's been finding it. I want to thank you for those who are finding me on TikTok at Stranger Danger Pod. And I want to give a shout out to those of you who have sent in comments. A lot of listeners to Stranger Danger use Spotify to listen to the show. And with Spotify, you can leave comments within specific episodes. And in fact, I got a comment from a listener just today. What timing? This comment actually came in only 2 hours ago from our good friend, Todd Rogers, who's called in. He's in the past, but this time he is going through the route of episode comments, which you can do too if you listen to Stranger Danger through Spotify. You can also, of course, if you're seeing this video on YouTube, post it, post comments there as well. But Todd Rogers wrote, I think I'm supposed to say, Mikey! There's like five exclamation points. I am a big fan of exclamation points. I use them all the time at work. He says, hi, that's how I'm reading it. Great episode as always. Is Linda Hamilton Future L? Oh, and great new song. Bye. Well, Todd, I won't address your question in the comment. So if you just see my reply, thanks for listening. I'll mention on the next episode. It's happening right now. It's happening live as I'm reading this. But I will talk about your question right here on the show. Is Linda Hamilton Future L? That thought never once crossed my noggin. It's a cool idea. Think about having a, I don't think you mean time travel where 11 meets 11, but Maybe you do. I'm wondering if you meet a time jump or if it's one of those things where we're seeing something and we don't realize we're seeing the future until the end. Like maybe they cross, we go back and forth. I'm just completely spitballing based on this comment. We see 11, we see Linda Hamilton, we see 11, we see Linda Hamilton. I just rewatched T2, by the way. Awesome. And we don't ever see them cross paths because they can't. One is 30, 60, 50 years in the future. That would be an interesting concept. I have to admit, when I saw Linda Hamilton, my first instinct was that she was some sort of government employee. And maybe that's because, isn't that what she plays on that Resident Alien, something like that? Resident Alien was a fun show that I watched the first season, started the second season, got distracted and never went back to it, which is just ridiculous. I need to go back and watch that. Linda Hamilton's always good, great in T2. And she was in that last Terminator 2. Guess what? She was great in that too. Do I think Linda Hamilton is future Elle? I'm gonna make a decisive decision, which I guess is how decisions are usually made, and say no, I don't think she is. But how cool would that be if she was? That would be pretty rad. The only other thing I wanted to mention was, I guess there's an article that Sadie Sink did recently, which I didn't read because I don't want to see anything spoilery at all. But I did see some headlines. It says she didn't think people would care about her Stranger Things character and forgot how hot it was to film the series. Another headline says, I feel a lot better about Max's fate in Stranger Things 5 now. See, even seeing that bothers me because I'm like, oh, she said something about Max's fate. And Sadie Sink teases Max's fate in Stranger Things final season. They love having me run. I don't even want to know that. I only want to know what I see in a trailer. I will watch a trailer. Oh, I will love a trailer. But that's it. I'm so afraid of seeing anything that influences or gives me ideas of what is coming, except for what is officially shown to us through, as I said, back behind the scenes videos like we saw, or trailers, which I would love to see. When would be a great time to get a trailer? Netflix is getting, is going to have NFL games on Christmas Day. So it's going to have a large audience of people watching Netflix on Christmas Day. I think that would be a wonderful time for us to get our first peek. I know it seems so far away. I know, I agree. But we saw the video from recently. They said they're halfway done filming. Now, obviously, I don't think they shoot everything and then go and edit it all together. I feel like there are teams and they are, you know, they have the filming, they have the post-production, and the duffers and the directors are bouncing back and forth between everyone. These are just completely speculation. But I can't imagine. I wonder if, like, they already have an episode done. Even though they're halfway done filming, maybe they have two in the can, three in the can, as they say in the biz. I don't know. The thought of that is exciting. And the wait is the hardest part, right? Isn't that what Tom Petty said? But that's why we're here now, just talking about our favorite show to get us through these long, long waits. My niece was in, I don't know, sixth grade or something like that. Now she's going to high school next year. If there was a season 6, I feel like it would be at her college graduation, which, fine, I'll wait and I'll watch it. But, you know, we know this is it. And all we can do in the meantime is talk about Stranger Things 4 and, you know, some books and comics when the time comes. But enough of that. Enough of looking at, I literally typed in Stranger Things on Google News and that's what popped up. Again, You can send in voicemail, strangerdangerpodcast.com/hotline, the Stranger Danger Hotline. You can do iTunes reviews, and you can add Spotify comments. Again, thank you, Todd, for this comment. I will publish it. It's going to be posted to the episode. I guess I hit publish, and I guess it gets added to the app, I think. I don't use Spotify to listen to podcasts. I use something called Pocket Casts, but I appreciate everyone who listens however they listen. Now, without any further ado, let's jump into minutes 40 to 50 in the Hellfire Club. Now, if you saw that on video, I leaned back. I thought it would add dramatics. Drama, I think, is the actual word of the English language. But let's jump right into it. This, we pick up exactly where we left off in the last 10 minutes. Joyce was in the middle of checking out that doll, kind of lifting its dress, a little weird, but seeing that it has nipples. And she's still on the phone with Murray, who happens to drop himself into a tub for what seems like a much needed soak. But he asks about wires. He asks about bugs or anything taped to the doll. And she noticed that it's cracked. And Murray's like, it's cracked? What do you mean? She's like, well, it's cracked. It looks like it was cracked and someone glued it back together. And he has an idea. He wants her to get some rope and something heavy because he wants to smash it. My first thought was, why not just get a hammer? But I'm pretty sure he addresses that. But not in this time. In fact, this is the last time we see him for the rest of these 10 minutes. In fact, these 10 minutes, it's funny, they're cut kind of in half to where the first half we spend with characters we love, and the second half we spend with characters that we are just meeting, and one of which, obviously, we fall in love with, the other of which we just don't get enough time. We just don't get enough time. But before all that, we get a fun scene with Jonathan and Argyle over in California, and we get Nancy with a guy at the school newspaper over in Hawkins. I don't think we know that his name is Fred yet, but come on, guys. We all know it's Fred. Sad, poor Fred. But I do like how they have this back and forth of how Nancy's talking to Jonathan. I'm sorry. Nancy's talking about Jonathan. Jonathan's talking about Nancy through Fred and Argyle. Both of their counterparts, Argyle and Fred, are trying to figure out, why isn't your boyfriend, your girlfriend, coming to visit you during spring break? They're both making excuses, both saying how they love each other, but they're too busy. You know, Jonathan has to look after his brother. He's waiting for his acceptance letter. Nancy has to work. She's taking the school newspaper. If she's going to do a newspaper, she's going to take it and make it the best school newspaper she possibly can. And that's what we love about her. I think the first thing that kind of I saw that made me go, oh man, get me jealous. I never had woodworking in high school. Now, I think part of this is showing, look, here's the kind of the burnouts. They're not really focused on schoolwork. I don't know if woodworking is a woodshop is like a required course, or if it's something that, you know, kids take in high school to kind of get an easy credit. I never had that. I never had that opportunity. The closest I came was we had I wonder if I talked about this during the old episode, like the original episode, but there's a vocational high school nearby that my town could go to, if you wanted to take up a vocation. If you don't know, that's like, there's different things. Like my friend's son he's like an electrician because he learned it at the high school. I did a camp there. So I did a summer camp. A bunch of us were going to join. I was the only one who actually joined. And guess what? I stuck by it. It was like a few weeks, and every week you kind of chose a different vocation. It was after eighth grade, right before high school. I think it was kind of previewing the high school, you know, hey, look what you can do at this high school. I never went there, but there was small engine repair. There was, maybe it was after freshman year. I did small engine repair. I took apart a lawnmower and put it back together. There was electrical work. I made a little siren with a battery, 9-volt battery that I had. I'm talking, I had this thing well into my college years, if not, you know, longer. Might have been as long as until I moved out of my parents' house. We did, what else did we do? Computer, like coding or computer, I don't know what it was, programming. And we did woodworking. I made like a sign that said Iron Maiden on it. And yeah, that was it. That was my kind of foray into woodworking. But Jonathan makes a pretty good bird feeder. Argyle makes a weed bird weeder with, you know, big weed. This episode, this 10 minutes has some weed moments, which again, it's a world I don't know anything about. But anyway, I do like their 10 minutes, those few minutes of Nancy and Jonathan kind of making excuses really for why they're not visiting each other. But then that is broken up by the next minute and a half that I call pure bliss. Now, if you know me, you might know that I am a big fan of the band Extreme. I bought their first record when it first came out, or tape, back in 1989. And I'll get back to that. And I think I knew this song the first time I remember hearing it was from Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. It plays in a montage of action going on in a mall. And I think that is kind of what they are for this few minutes. It's kind of paying homage to that montage with a montage of its own. I've seen Extreme in concert multiple times. The last time I saw them was literally last summer, almost about a year ago to the day. I saw Extreme with Living Color. If you don't know Living Color, the Cult of Personality, and I mean, there's a guy who sounds better, just as good if not better now than he did back in the 80s. I mean, I'm not kidding at all. Unbelievable. But again, they open for one of my favorite bands, Extreme. I've always loved this song. I love when they play it live. And you're going to say to yourself, wait, the album didn't come out till 1989? But this takes place in 1986. And I'm like, you know what? That wasn't a mistake. At first I thought, oh no, what are they doing here? And it took me out of it for a moment. That was not a mistake, because if you remember back in the first season of Stranger Things, we had a wonderfully dramatic, emotional moment with what they thought was the body of Will Byers. And they had Peter Gabriel's cover of the David Bowie classic Heroes playing. But guess what? Even though that's an old David Bowie song, that song didn't come out. Peter Gabriel did not do that song until 2010. So it's not that, you know, this wasn't a mistake. This was a choice by the creators of the show to give us a song that just emotionally hits and emotionally fits. And it does here with spades, because it's fun. The song is fun. And this scene is fun. Dustin and Mike are scouring the school looking for someone to join Hellfire just for that night. Mike, of course, starts with Nancy. Dustin starts with Steve. Both of them strike out. I do love that Dustin says to Steve, you're just jealous that I have another, an older adult friend? And Steve was like, ooh, like he didn't like that at all. They strike out everywhere they go. The best reaction is from Max. Speaking of Sadie Sink, the best reaction is Max going, if I join, I get to get one of those great shirts, those awesome shirts. Awesome. Dustin falls for it at first, but then he realizes that she's being sarcastic. So they seem like they're both dejected. They meet up outside of school and realize, you know, high school sucks, so let's not worry about high school. Dustin runs off to the middle school. I still think that he yelled at that kid on a skateboard to wear a helmet. I still think that was ad-libbed. I don't know for sure, but that was, I remember thinking that the first time, and I'm thinking that this time as well. As they run off to the high school, that takes us pretty much to the 5-minute mark. And now we get off to a very different second 5 minutes, because when they're making their way up, Chrissy is making her way through the parking lot into the woods. And for the next 5 minutes, we are with two characters that we've only just met for a few seconds. In fact, we really haven't met Chrissy. This is our first introduction to her. Well, no, that's not true. We got her in the stall of the bathroom. So this isn't our introduction to her, but this is our first time to actually spend some time with her. Really, when you think about it, we had that scene with her in the gym. We had the moment with her in the bathroom, like seeing some sort of monster, but then no like character development, really. Just the high school cheerleader. I shouldn't say no character development, because first she starts off, you think she's the perfect cheerleader. Then you see she has some sort of eating disorder and something is haunting her. So take everything back I said, but this is our first time to get some time with her. Okay, that's what it really is. We get to talk to her. We get to see her. She goes into the woods, and it's kind of icky and scary. We see something freaky. We see this giant, the scariest grandfather clock I've ever seen, sticking out of a tree, which is frightening. And it starts ticking. It chimes. You get spiders pouring out of it. And the time it says is about 2:56, and I'm not sure. But we get that first crack, of course, that crack, right? You know, that X crack that I think is foreshadowing to the future, which is usually what foreshadowing means. She's freaked out. She backs up and boom, bumps right into Eddie. He's like, oh. And when she turns around, the clock's gone. But we find out that Chrissy Cunningham is actually in the woods to meet Eddie and to buy drugs. But it turns out they've actually met before. So he asks if she's okay, and she mentions how, you know, do you ever feel like you're going crazy? And he's like, oh yeah, almost every day, which kind of diffuses things. And she smiles and laughs, and he's like, you know, we've met before. First he's like, she's like, you're not like I imagine. He's like, oh, you thought I'd be all scary? He goes, I thought you'd be scary too. He goes, you know, we've met before. She had no recollection of, what is it, middle school, junior high talent show. She did her cheerleading. He thought it was pretty cool. And he was there with his band, Corroded Coffin, which is an amazing name for a band. But she remembers. She remembered Corroded Coffin. She remembered the band name, which he definitely loved. How, you know, said he was good. Said he used to play guitar. He's like, I still do. I think she even said you should come see us play sometime. Did he say that? I think he did. But or maybe it happens and it hasn't happened yet. I'm not sure. But he's like, listen, compliments go a long way. Flattery goes a long way. And he's like, for that, I'm going to give you a discount. A discount of $15. And oh, sorry. That's where it ends. That's where our time comes to an end for these 10 minutes. So a 25% discount, I think he said, $15 for some sort of drugs. I don't know exactly what it is. And I have no idea if that's a good deal or not. Again, I have never purchased any sort of illegal drug in my life. I wouldn't even know how much it costs to get the legal stuff that you can get now in Massachusetts. I don't know. But I do know that that Eddie is a nice guy to be able to offer a nice discount to Chrissy. And, you know, I don't want to talk about how it ends, how the deal actually ends, but because that's another time, I wonder if that's not even next episode. Let's put it that way. We still have some time before we get there. But ooh, baby, if this was a fun 10 minutes, because we got one little glimpse of what Joyce and Murray are going to be doing. We got one little glimpse of Nancy and Jonathan having their issues, or saying they're not having issues, but they're having some sort of issues. We get a couple moments of Mike and Dustin, which were fun, and they have a plan to try to figure out what they can do with Hellfire. And then we get Eddie and Chrissy. We get the scary clock, something in the woods. So we get another like haunt, like something's happening to Chrissy. You know, like anytime we see her now, we should be scared that something bad's going to happen. Especially when you realize, you know, if you're watching that last 10 minutes, you're like, oh, they're together towards the end of this episode. That can't be good for either one of them. But great 10 minutes. It gets us some character development, gets us progressing more into the episode. But really, it's just kind of setting things up until that last moment of you get a punch in the face, which is like, whoa, but that is not for today. I can't break the rules. I feel like I'm already breaking the rules now, and I don't want to get in trouble. I don't want to be reprimanded, but I do want to thank you for listening, for watching, for finding this show. I want to thank Todd Rogers for sending in his comment. Again, please send in comments, send in voicemails, send in emails, whatever you can. Go to StrangerDangerPodcast.com to see all that stuff. And yeah, I think that's it. Now, you can follow the show on Twitter. It's StrangerDPod, on TikTok at StrangerDangerPod. And you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Threads, Mastodon.social, and Blue Sky at Geek Mentality. Yeah, I think that's it. Have you guys seen the new trailer for the new Star Wars show, Skeleton Crew? It's like, oh, it's Star Wars with a bunch of kids going on an adventure? Oh, sign me up. If you are interested in hearing me talk about it, check out The Mandalorian Man. It's another podcast I do. I will be doing a full episode-by-episode review of The Skeleton Crew, but that's not till December. Until then, you can find me here talking to you guys about Stranger Things 4. So listen, that's it. I'm done. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for subscribing. Stay Stranger, my friends. And remember, we are the ones who will keep Stranger Things alive forever. Fans, not experts.